shake your camera a little bit. Okay, yeah, your camera too.
Alright, guys, you should be getting about 15
seconds.
So, Tom,
your camera too. Alright. Camera one. Tom, you're gonna be mainly close up shots, and whenever it gets low to the lights on, it's gonna be main cam.
Can you take that off?
Welcome into Memorial Stadium on a overcast afternoon here in Westerville, Ohio. Jeff Murtaugh with you, Will Day over here to my right, and it's going to be a good matchup this evening. We've got the Otterbein Cardinals taking on the Baldwin Wallace Yellow Jackets, and what should be a very good matchup.
Absolutely. You know, Baldwin Wallace traveling here to Memorial Stadium. Both teams with an even record right now of 4-2. And 4-1 in the OAC.
Yeah, you know, they've got identical records. They're both on three-game winning streaks, and there's a lot on the line here for these senior classes. Otterbein has won the last three meetings, and Baldwin Wallace obviously has lost the last three meetings, and both senior classes are trying to, Otterbein trying to keep it that way, and the Yellow Jackets trying to change it up. So.
I know this is especially important for quarterback number 15, Kevin Green, who was hoping to make his 4-0 win against Baldwin Wallace.
Yeah, you know, and Kevin Green's going to be a big part of the offense today. He's going to be starting quarterback for the Cardinals. He had a nice game last week. But the story of last week's game was the defense. They forced four turnovers on four straight possessions in the second half to really take control of that game against Wilmington that Otterbein ended up winning. I believe the score was 28-21 in that game. So a big win, a close game, but a big win for the Cardinals.
Mm-hmm. It'll be interesting to see if Otterbein can pull ahead more this game. Their usual record this season is having quite close games, usually by one possession.
Yeah, both teams have had very close games all season long. Otterbein loses big first week of the season to Buffalo State, and then they have a 10-point game at Marietta. They beat Wilmington pretty good, and then they lose a fairly close one to Heidelberg. They win a tighter one at Capitol, and then last week's one-possession game. On the flip side, Baldwin Wallace, every single game except for one win against Marietta has been a one-possession game, so we expect it to be a pretty tight one today.
Absolutely. And I know there's going to be a lot of focus on Baldwin Wallace's quarterback, number 10, Tyler Moglen, who is said to be one of the better quarterbacks in this conference.
Yeah, he's a very good dual-threat quarterback. He's thrown for over 1,500 yards, I believe, and rushed for over 500. So, you know, he's on the start. He's one of their better players, and he's definitely the leader on the offense. So it's going to be up to that Cardinals defense to try and keep him under control this
Absolutely.
Evening.
I know during this week's coach chat, they were talking about the defense. They were going to have to keep Tyler from running the ball because we've got a fairly good defense against their pass game.
Yeah, you know, the Cardinals have been playing very good pass defense, but it's that run defense that's really hurt them the last few weeks. And with a mobile quarterback, it makes it that much harder because not only do you have to worry about the running back, but you have to worry about the quarterback sneaking out and hurting you for a big play down the field with his legs as well as his arm.
Absolutely. And I know, speaking on the other side for the Cardinal offense, good to see John Piles back out there on run back.
Yeah, Piles, you know, he's been one of the better players for the Cardinals. He started off the season a little bit slowly as far as rushing the ball goes, and then he broke out against Capitol. He set the school record with a 99-yard rushing touchdown to break that game open, and since then he's been very good. He had a little bit of a slow game last week, but still he's going to carry the team in the running game. Now the Cardinals are about ready to take the field as they
here come the Cardinals.
They run through the bands, trailing after the cheerleading squad with the CARDS flag.
Absolutely. And here comes Baldwin Wallace from the other side of the field.
Yeah, Baldwin Wallace now taking the field. They no longer have the visitor bleachers over there, so that's quite a big ovation for them.
Right, right.
But for the Cardinals, the fans are always excited to see him, even though the weather today might not be the best. It rained earlier, but it's just overcast now, and it's looking like it's going to be a nice game, a nice day for some football.
Mm-hmm. Should be interesting as we have a couple of substitutions on the Baldwin-Wallace side.
Yeah, there's a few injuries for both teams. You know, Otterbein missing Cole Benner,
mm-hmm.
and then on the defensive side, Nick Toledo is out of the starting lineup, but he's available and may see some playing time today. And then Baldwin-Wallace has a few players who are out of the game today.
Right. And it looks like we're about ready to kick this thing off here, ladies and gentlemen.
Otterbein's going to be kicking off to Baldwin-Wallace. So they will have the ball to start the second half. They were trailing at the half last week, 15-10.
Mm-hmm.
But then they had forced those four consecutive turnovers to really, you know, take control of that game. And
one of the things I like a lot about the Cardinal defense is that they're excellent in the red zone. They were able to stop a lot of drives coming from the opposite team.
Yeah, you know, they've had, when Piles had that 99-yard touchdown run, it came after four straight plays from inside the five-yard line that Capital was unable to score on.
Right.
And in the red zone, Otterbein's done very well. They've been susceptible to some big plays, and Baldwin-Wallace has as well. The last 2 weeks, Baldwin-Wallace has given up a number of plays over 30 yards that have resulted in touchdowns.
And mm-hmm. And looks like we're about ready to kick off. Number 39, Abbas Cisse.
Well, San Filippo is going to be kicking this one off, and it's down to the 2-yard line is where it'll be taken. And coming down to the near side is the return man. He breaks free. He's out across the 40-yard line, and he's all the way past the 45. A flag comes in from way downfield. It's Austin Smith. He's taken down at his own 47-yard line, but there is a flag, and it looks like it's going to be a hold on the Yellow Jackets. The officials confer. We'll see where the spot is. It is going to be a hold on Baldwin-Wallace.
Mm-hmm. It'll be a 10-yard penalty from the yellow flag.
And we'll see where they decided that hold occurred. And it's going to lose them a huge chunk of yardage.
We'll put them back to about the 35-yard line.
Down they go, you know, I guess it wasn't as bad as I originally thought. They go from about the 47 back to just inside the 35-yard line, and that's where Moglen is going to take over this offense. He comes out in the gun. We typically see offenses out in the gun these days. He's got his back, Reed, right behind him.
Mm-hmm. The snap.
Yep. And he looks to pass far side. And it's caught out there by the receiver,
Mike Wagner.
And it's taken down for a first down over to the 49-yard line.
Quite a simple pass, yet effective.
Yeah, it gets the job done. It's a little hook out on the far side. He breaks through the first tackle, picks up a first down.
And Baldwin-Wallace, not really in a hurry. They get back up to the line without a huddle, though, and Moglen directs his lineman with the play call and checks his receivers. He goes with the hard count, takes the snap, hands it off up the middle, and diving forward for about 2 yards is the back.
Isaac Reed on the carry.
Reed for a carry of about 2-3 yards.
Yeah, nice little gain on first down. To get this offense moving, they had a nice pass last time, and now they go with the run, and here they're just across midfield already to the 48 of Otterbein, and Moglen hasn't run yet, but we're only two plays into this drive, and Otterbein's having a little trouble. They want to blitz, but they are getting a hard time reading this as Moglen rolls to his right, hits the receiver, who's shoved out of bounds at the 39.
Brian Cook.
That's Brian Cook, and it'll be enough for a first down.
I don't know. It seems that the Cardinal defense seems almost as if they're not quite awake yet for today's game.
Yeah, they're kind of wandering around. They're looking like they're trying to get a read on Moglen's and his snap count. He's clapping his hands, so you'd think that on the first clap, that'd be when he's taking it, but twice already, he's not taking it on that first clap and read the defense.
And rather the second clap.
Yep. Now he changes the play at the line of scrimmage. Two receivers to his left. He moves Reed to his right. And
oh, the blitz from number 23.
Yeah, 23 comes in. He was offside with a flag on the play. He would have gotten to Moglen, but he was across the line early.
On the defense, number 23.
5-yard penalty.
First down.
And it'll be first down and five now from the 35 of Otterbein.
Penalty marks the ball at the 35-yard line. First down, five.
Have a pause on the field.
Yeah, they move it forward 5 yards. And Moglen has Reed to his left, has three receivers to his left at the top of the screen. Now moves up to the line, changes the play, calls out to his receivers. Takes the snap, looks to pass. He's looking out on the left. There's a late blitz. He throws it deep.
Deep. Oh, and is caught.
Yeah, it's caught down there. A readjustment by his receiver, Brian Cook, who came back for that ball and made the catch down at the 6-yard line.
They will quickly readjust. Get ready for the next snap.
It was Boniface who made the tackle there.
Football, first and goal.
And now it's a first and goal from the six. They go with the hard count again, and now Moglen checks the sideline for the play. Otterbein nearly jumped off sides again.
That seems to be quite the tactic so far this game.
They just have to get that timing down. He takes the snap, hands it off up the middle to Reed, and Reed fights his way through some defenders and is down just short of the goal line at the one.
And it will be second and goal.
Dalton Jarvis and Drew Herbert.
Second and goal now. And they're going to go quickly here as the Otterbein defense tries to get it in there. And Reed takes the handoff and goes right up the middle into the end zone before the Cardinals could really get set. And it's going to be 6-0 in favor of the Yellow Jackets.
Special teams will come out onto the field for the extra point.
Yeah, that run, I mean, they hadn't gone quickly all game so far on that first drive, and then they rush up to the line after the first down carry and catch the defense off guard, and they walk right into the end zone. We await the extra point. The snap is high. The kick is up, and it's good, so it's going to make the score. Baldwin Wallace 7 and Otterbein 0.
And I'll be interested to see if that'll be the tactic for the Yellow Jackets today, especially on offense, this change of tempo throughout the game.
Yeah, it's really confused Otterbein so far is they have Moglen go behind the line. He's been adjusting the play a number of times already, but when he takes a snap, he claps his hands, and Otterbein is leading that, but it's really only been 50-50 so far that he's gone on that first clap, so it's really keeping the defense off guard.
Ohio Health, believe in we. Baldwin Wallace scoring drive, 6 plays, 65 yards, 2 minutes, 56 seconds off the clock.
You heard the 6 play, 56 yard scoring drive for the Yellow Jackets.
Now Baldwin Wallace will set up for the kickoff.
A very effective drive that time. Didn't have to pass too much, but they did have the long one down to the 5-yard line and Byron Cook.
Number 85, Riley Jones will kick off.
Hammond and Johnson back to return for the Cardinals. It's going to be Hammond up near the 14-yard line. He's going to try and come to the near side. He's got a lane, and he bursts through and gets tripped up out at the 35-yard line.
B. Seeley on the tackle for the Yellow Jackets.
B. Seeley on the tackle for the Yellow Jackets.
He had a nice little hole there and
turn of 21 yards
was
to the
almost
35.
Through it, but he was just grabbed by Ram around the shoe and tripped up the 35. But nice starting field position for the Cardinals here.
All right, now it's time to have Green get his hands on the ball, see what he can do.
Yeah, Green will look to answer that drive with one of his own, and he's got Piles in the backfield with him. He's going to hand it to Piles going right, and Piles is met right at the line of scrimmage for no gain.
Piles with the carry.
Yeah, quite a tough defense to break through for Piles.
Yeah, the The front four that time were not allowing any penetration as they just collapsed right on him, and he couldn't gain any forward momentum as Green has piles to his right, three receivers to his right at the top of the screen, one to the left on the bottom of the screen, and he takes the snap
and
passes it himself.
Oh.
He faked the handoff to Piles and then ran it across the right side out across the 40. So an interesting play there is Piles threw his hands up in the air on the snap like there was a fumble. You know, whatever, I don't know if that was what affected them, but they gained about 6 yards, so it's a third and four.
We've got a 2-2 formation.
Yeah, two receivers to both sides of Green. He looks to pass, throws it over on the right side. The catch is made and driven out of bounds is his receiver. But that'll be enough
Kevin
for a
Green
first down.
Julian Lowe.
That's Julian Lowe, the leading receiver in the OAC. He's actually ranked eighth in the entire country.
Line. Oh, really?
Yeah, in completions.
Otterbein football, first and 10.
He's got another one there, and it's good enough for a first down out to the 47-yard line.
See Green switch up formation once more.
Yeah, he sends Hammond out to the left, and he's going to swing it out to Hammond. It's a bad pass.
Oh.
It's incomplete, and they'll rule it
Kevin
a forward pass, so just an incompletion and not a fumble there. Fortunate, it was very close to being a lateral.
Almost.
Second and 10, at the road 47.
It's a questionable play, really, having Piles run out there. Is, I mean, it really telegraphs what you're going to do. And the defense was ready for it, so even if he had caught it, I don't know if he'd have gained much. As Green now surveys the defense once again, since
and
Piles.
I think they're doing the same play again. Or
they're going to fake it over there. Now he's looking to throw it deep. Now Green's just going to run it.
And we'll be brought down to the 49-yard line.
He only gains about 2 on the play. He was looking deep for Logan Stepp on the far side, but he was covered pretty well, and Green just decides to run it. Now Connor Lucas into the game. He's really pass-catching back type receiver, as he's very small. It's only 5'5". Green calls the play out to his receivers, motions Hammond to his right. It's still Piles, and there's a free play now. He's going to throw it deep.
Flag on the play, however.
Nearly an amazing catch on the far side by Logan Stepp. He went up with one hand and almost brought it in, but as he was knocked to the ground, it came out, but it looks like it's going to be a offsides on Baldwin Wallace.
Number 8, 5-yard penalty. Everything. Third down.
5-yard penalty. Will be third down at about the 46-yard line.
It's a third down and manageable
here.
Third
down 3.
It's only 3. It's a long 3. But they come in the same formation. And Green takes the snap. Throws a quick over on the right side, but right there to make the tackle. It was the Yellow Jackets defense, and Stepp is brought down at the line of scrimmage. And it looks like the offense is going to stay on the field here.
All right. Coaches decide to push the ball, see if they can go for that first down.
Yeah, 4th and 3. And the officials are conferring about something. I'm not sure what it is. I didn't see a penalty on the play, but they're talking about something. They're now talking to the Yellow Jackets head coach out on the far side.
Both coaches from, or two of the coaches from Cardinals are out on the field. Yep. Quite a bit of confusion.
And now the refs come over to talk to head coach Tim Dow.
Taking camera 1. Legal block number 56 on the offense. That penalty declined. It'll be 4th down.
So there was an illegal chop block called on the center of the Cardinals, but it'll be declined, which is interesting because the Cardinals are still going to go for it on 4th. So it's a 4th and 3.
Crowd getting excited.
Now the entire Cardinal line checks for the play. Green takes it, and it's just going to be a quick kick. He punts this one down. There's no one back. And it's inside the 10. It's rolling down near the 5, and it'll be down Jets outside the 5-yard line at the 6. So a nice decision there from Coach Dapp to go with a little quick kick and pin them back deep.
Mm-hmm.
Moglen and the Yellow Jackets will start this drive from their own 6-yard line.
It'll be interesting to see if the Cardinal defense can push these guys back, maybe for a touchback.
Yeah, you know, they're going to have to get their timing down a little bit better, as Moglen's kept them off balance so far. And with 9:05 to go here in the first quarter, it's
Baldwin
Wallace 7, Otterbein nothing. But this Otterbein defense has a good chance for a big stop.
Starting at the 5-yard line, I believe.
Yeah, just outside the 5, and right now the refs are talking about something again.
Camera 2, zoom in on the refs, please.
And Coach Dapp is talking to an official, so we're not sure what this one's about.
Formation has not even been set, so I'm not quite sure exactly what the problem could be.
Camera 3, zoom in.
It must be something that happened on the punt, but it's quite delayed.
And no flags were thrown.
Yeah, we never saw any flags, and they still confer.
All right, follow Coach Dow off the field.
The officials move back into position. And with no explanation, this drive is going to start from the 6-yard line. And Moglen from the gun. Two receivers to his left. He's going to take the snap, hand it off up the middle. And piling out to the 10-yard line is the back, Isaac Reed. No, that's actually the backup, Austin Smith.
Austin Smith on the carry.
It'll be a carry for about 4 yards.
Leave
the Yellow Jackets offense, or 2nd and 6.
Second down and 6.
Ready, camera 1.
For the Yellow Jackets. Moglen goes on the second clap this time, and it's going to be a quick screen out to the left. The receiver makes a move and is out across the 20, out to the 24-yard line.
Pass complete to Trevor George.
It's Trevor George on the reception for a first down.
And Dustin McFadden come out on the tackle. 13 yards to the 24.
13-yard gain for the Yellow Jackets to the 24.
First and 10.
First and 10 for Baldwin Wallace.
Yet another first down for the Yellow Jackets, and they're moving the ball again.
There you go, camera 3.
It's Moglen. We'll go on the second clap. It's the same play over to the left. And an 8-yard pickup on first down. It's Trevor George again.
Once again, we see the second clap snap coming from Moglen.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to say, a second clap snap. Going to bring up a 2nd and 3 for the Cardinals. Or not for the Cardinals. For the Cardinals defense to try and prevent.
Absolutely.
As Moglen will go on the second clap, hands it off up the middle. And they've got enough for a first down out to the 38-yard line. And that's Austin Smith again.
Austin Smith carries. Stephen Carpenter and Drew.
The Yellow Jackets seem to be setting up for a pass play, yet tend to be running it off and breaking through the Cardinal defense.
Yeah, you know, and they might be waiting to hit him for a big pass like they did in that first drive, as they have been running it pretty well on this one, and Smith stays in the game behind Moglen. He's got three receivers to his right. He motions Smith to the right.
Second clap.
Yeah, the snap comes, and he throws a screen. It was behind the receiver, but he makes the catch, and he's pushed out of bounds at the 40 for a gain of about 2 yards. So that was nearly a mistake that time by Moglen, is if he throws it behind him and it hits the ground, that's a fumble.
Mm-hmm.
George is able to recover and make the catch and gain about a yard. They mark him out, actually, at the 39-yard line.
All right, Cardinals set up once more.
Tilt
Moglen. The split formation, looks to pass, looks deep over the right side, has his man.
Brought down about the 50-yard line.
He hooks back and makes the reception. That's Tommy Fuller right at midfield, and that's going to be enough for another Baldwin-Wallace first down.
You know, I tell you, Jeff, it looks like the Cardinal defense is just afraid to get up close to these guys.
Yeah, they're very tentative as they're struggling with this snap count. I mean, it's really had them on their heels all game so far, and they're going to have to do something about it if they want to get back in this game. It's Moglen. Motions as a receiver to the left, and he hands it to him. And he's going to be brought down at the 46-yard line for about 3 yards.
Jordan Boniface and Zach Davis combined on the stop.
Jordan Boniface and Zach Davis for the stop.
47, second down three.
Second down and three.
Down seven.
Actually, second down and seven.
Oh, my apologies.
It's, as he correctly stated now. And Moglen remains in the shotgun. And first clap, checks the sideline, gets the play call. And now takes the snap, fakes the handoff off the middle, rolls to his right. And he's pressured. He's going to keep it. He runs back all the way to the left, and he breaks through. And now he's got a lane to the sideline, and he runs out of bounds inside the 30 at the 29. The Moglen, nice footwork there to get down to the 29-yard line and pick up yet another Yellow Jacket first down.
Yep, that was a carry from Moglen for about...
For
about 22 yards.
It was a very athletic move as he came to his right and then had to roll all the way back to his left to pick up that yardage.
And had to cut through his own offensive line.
Yeah, the offensive line was all coming right, and he just ran right around him.
There's the Coach Dowd yelling at his defense.
Yeah, yelling out instruction. As Moglen sends the receiver in motion again, fakes the handoff to him. He's going to look to pass over the middle. Now he floats it down the left sideline, and it's caught right at the 10. That's Tommy Fuller on the reception.
All right, let's see if this Cardinal defense can stop these guys in the red zone as it's brought down within the 10.
Yeah, they're now inside the red zone at the 10-yard line. It'll be a first and goal from the 10.
Baldwin-Wallace football, first and goal.
Band and cheerleaders up on their feet, trying to give the Cardinals a bit of motivation.
Yeah, and they're going to need it here to keep this tough offense out of the end zone and force a field goal attempt or possibly a turnover. So they trail 7-0 with 4:05 to go in this first quarter. Moglen remains in the gun, sends the receiver in motion to the right. He fakes the handoff to him. Now he's going to keep it and go left. And he weaves his way through the defense and into the end zone for a Baldwin-Wallace touchdown. And he really didn't see too much resistance on that run.
No. No, and that is Baldwin-Wallace's second drive and second touchdown in a row.
Yeah, it's not promising for this Cardinal defense. They've not been able to figure out Tyler Moglen and his snap count.
Is a strange
nothing.
Tempo.
Joseph Otis attempting the extra point.
13-0 now as Moglen is in there to hold the extra point. Snap is back. The kick is up. And it is good.
Kick is good.
So that's going to make the score 14-0 for Baldwin-Wallace. A 3:55 to go here in this first quarter.
Cardinal offensive line getting a talking to from the offensive coordinator.
They really need a drive here as they can't afford to get down any further in this game against what's been a very good team all season long.
Plenty of time left in this first quarter.
Yeah, lots of time left here in the game, but you don't want to let this one get out of hand early, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be Hammond.
Baldwin-Wallace scoring drive, 10 plays, 95 yards, 5 minutes, 10 seconds off the clock. 9-yard run.
Hammond as well as 31 to return this kick. Christian Johnson.
Riley Jones kicking off for Baldwin Wallace.
And the kick is away. It's a short one, and this one is headed for the sidelines, and it's going to go out of bounds.
Marker on the kick.
So not a good kick there, as Otterbein's going to have very good starting field position all the way out near the 40-yard line.
Mm-hmm.
The mistake by the Yellow Jackets, and I'm sure their coaching staff is not happy about that one.
Certainly not. Although they can't be too upset considering the scoreline so far.
Yeah, I'm sure they're thrilled with the 14-0 lead, but you don't want to give Otterbein any extra momentum here like that punt out of bounds will do. Is the Cardinals are going to start from their own 35. It's not too many yards on that penalty, as the punt really only went out of bounds at the 25-yard line. It was not a good one.
No.
There's a light breeze blowing in that direction, but not a heavy one, and Green out of the gun with Piles. He's going to hand it to Piles over the right side. Piles breaks free into the secondary. He's got a block.
John Piles
and is tackled down after a very nice gain out to the 46-yard line.
Excellent run by Piles.
Yeah, he hit that hole quickly and exploded into the secondary. And now they're going to run the very same play, and Piles gets to the outside. But he probably got there because of a hold, because there's a penalty marker down, and he only gained up a yard on the play. So this one's probably coming back.
Brock Cole on the tackle for BW.
Ball brought down on the 45.
Ready, camera two, taking camera two.
Holding number 56, the offense. 10-yard penalty.
Be a charge of holding number 56 on the offense.
That's the second penalty on number 56, the center. That's Jacob Schaefer, who is playing his fourth game at center this season. He switched halfway through with Grant Knoppenberger, who is now at left guard.
First down, 20.
It's going to bring up a first and 20. And now the officials,
once again, stopping the play.
They stop play to reset the game clock, I suppose, and the clock continues to run as Green sends the receiver in motion, pitches it to him. He's coming to the near side. He tries to get the corner and sneaks through, and he's shoved out of bounds just short of the midfield, and that's Julian Lowe, a pickup of about 4 yards.
Tackle out of bounds by Theodore Washington.
You know, I said it earlier, and I'll say it again. Tempo seems to be a major part of this game.
Yeah, Otterbein not moving with too much of a sense of urgency.
Second down, 15.
But, you know, they don't huddle, and Green directs his offense on the fly. He stays in the gun with Piles behind him, and he fakes the handoff to Piles. He's looking to pass, and now he's pressured, and he's thrown down for a loss of a yard, but that's a sack.
Will be brought down by number 86.
Jaylen Brown, on the tackle for the Yellow Jackets.
Jaylen Brown with the sack, and Kevin Green just held that one too long. He had time and didn't see anyone open, and then got pressured by three Yellow Jackets and was thrown for a loss, and now it's going to bring up a third and 16. Not a situation you really want to be in, as he goes with an empty backfield and five wide. Two to his left, three to his right. And he takes the snap, looks to pass, throws it short over the middle to Julian Lowe, who gets to the original first down marker. But that's going to be still 10 yards short of the first down. And they will most likely go for it again, or leave the offense out and probably do that little quick punt they did last time.
Fourth down and 10, yeah, quite possibly.
There's a little bit of formation shifting.
Although there was still a minute and a half left in the quarter.
Yeah, a minute 30 to go here in the first quarter. I wouldn't be surprised if Green punts this one away. And now Otterbein's going to take a timeout to talk this one over.
Otterbein, there first.
Camera three,
on the Ohio Athletic Conference.
So the Otterbein offense has really not been able to get too much going on. Baldwin Wallace's offense hasn't had any trouble. They've had the ball twice, and they've scored twice.
Now, as we've talked about, Tyler Moglen for the Yellow Jackets, been versatile in both passing and running.
Yeah, he's already thrown for a touchdown. No, he's run for a touchdown and had a few nice passes that they've gained really good chunks of yardage on. So he's shown off both facets of his game, and now Otterbein breaks the huddle to send out the punt unit. Fourth and 10 from the Yellow Jacket 45. They'll look to punt this one away.
Ace. Stoppage in play.
Yeah. Now Baldwin Wallace is going to take a timeout. So they were not expecting Otterbein to punt that one away. They didn't have the right personnel out on the field, and they'll take a timeout to match up. It'd be interesting to see if Otterbein decides to come out and go for it here on fourth after Baldwin Wallace changes their personnel again. Unlikely, though, is Kevin Green's over here on the sideline with his helmet off.
I'm not seeing a change in lineup.
Yeah, the same personnel remain on the field, and it will most likely be a punt here on 4th and 10 from the 45. They back the ball up a yard. I guess it's on the 46.
I believe the wind's picked up a little bit. I wonder if that'll have any effect in the punt.
Yeah, the wind now blowing fairly strong from right to left.
Joe Sanfilippo.
Still no rain.
Yeah, no rain yet. And Sanfilippo takes the high snap, boots this one away. It's going to be fielded down at the 6-yard line. So for the second straight drive, the Yellow Jackets are going to have to start from their own six. And the Otterbein defense comes back onto the field with a chance to prevent any more damage, as they already trail this one 14-0.
And with just over a minute left in the quarter, it'll be interesting to see if the coaches are telling Cardinal defense to change the lineup any.
Yeah, I don't know what they're going to have to do, but they're going to have to do something, because the defense is struggling to contain Moglen here. And, I mean, if they fall behind any further, it's going to be very tough to climb out of that hole. As Moglen takes the snap, hands it off up the middle, and the back is out across the 10, out to the 11-yard line, and that is
Adam Blake on the carry.
32, Adam Blake, so the third running back to carry the ball already in this game for the Yellow Jackets.
Gain of 5 to the 12, second down 5.
That'll be a gain of 5 yards to about the 12-yard line.
Yeah. It's going to bring up a 2nd and 5 as the time is under a minute here in this first quarter. And Moglen from the gun. Takes the snap, hands it off up the middle. Blake again, and he piles ahead for another 6 yards, and that's going to be enough for Baldwin Wallace's first down.
Adam Blake carries.
Just under 30 seconds left in the quarter.
That may be the last play of the first quarter here.
Andre Douglas.
It'll depend on how Baldwin Wallace wants to attack here, and it looks like that will be the last play of the first quarter.
All right.
Baldwin Wallace football, 1st and 10.
The teams head to the sideline as there's under 10 seconds on this first quarter clock, and they're going to flip sides of the field. So Baldwin Wallace will be moving with the wind at their back, as they already lead this one 14-0.
Baldwin Wallace 14, Otterbein nothing.
Well, Jeff, if you're down there, what are you telling the teams?
Well, you know, on the Otterbein side of things, you got to stay focused. You can't, you know, you got to keep doing what you're doing, and you got to get a little more focused up to try and control this offense. The Otterbein offense hasn't played too bad. They've moved the ball fairly well. They do have the 2 punts, but they've moved the ball, and now they just need to get a big stop to get their offense some momentum.
Baldwin Wallace's Isaac Reed has been especially important for them, especially these last two drives.
Yeah, he went into the end zone on the first drive, and we haven't seen him too much, but he's been good to mix up the pace and keep some of the pressure off Moglen.
Second quarter begins. Baldwin Wallace football, first and 10 at their own 18.
Baldwin Wallace, yep, they have a first and 10 at their 18, and apologize there.
No worries.
It is. Moglen comes out with one back behind him, and he's going to look to pass here. Now he's going to keep it himself and run right up the middle.
Tyler Moglen, the ball carrier.
And he is dropped after gaining about 1 yard.
Just got the stats from the first quarter. 9 first downs for Baldwin Ross, while Otterbutton only had 2.
And it is 14-0, so
second down, 9.
That would explain it right there. The lack of first downs for the Cardinals is definitely a problem. And they've got a chance here with a 2nd and 9 from the 19 to hold this Baldwin Wallace offense down. Moglen takes the snap, looks to pass, steps up in the pocket, throws it right over the middle.
Tommy
and it's caught
pass complete to Tommy
at
Fuller.
The 30, and Tommy Fuller goes down there, but it's enough for another first down.
By Jordan Schell.
Be about 12 yards to the 31-yard line.
Baldwin Wallace football, first and 10.
And another first down for the Yellow Jackets.
Yep, another first down is they're going to have to buckle down again to try and force a punt or force a turnover. They had 4 last week. So we'll see what they can do here. And Moglen takes the snap, hands off up the middle. And almost breaking through there is the back, Adam Blake. But he stopped for a short gain of about 2 yards.
And Andre Douglas on the stop.
Now,
2 yards to the 33s, second down 8.
Going over the first quarter stats, Baldwin Wallace with about 9.5 minutes of possession time, while only Otterbein with 5.5.
Yeah, and I mean, if you dominate time of possession, you generally tend to dominate the game, and that's how it's been so far. And it doesn't look like it's in any danger of changing yet, as Moglen motions Blake to his right, now takes the snap, hands it off to Blake up the middle, and he is met immediately and dropped right at the line of scrimmage.
Adam Blake carries.
That was Adam Blake.
Going to bring up a 3rd down and 8 for the Yellow Jackets.
Gain of a yard to the 34, 3rd down.
Seems to be a stoppage of the play once more, bringing out the coaches for the read.
Yeah, not too much huddling these days from offenses. And Moglen will take the snap. He's going to look to pass, floats it out to his back, Blake out of the backfield, and Blake, the ball's on the ground. And the officials are going to say he never caught it, so that's going to bring up a 4th down.
Pass intended for Adam Blake, incomplete.
And the Cardinals are fortunate that he didn't catch that because he had room to run out there and probably would have picked up yet another 1st down.
Mm-hmm.
4th and 7, Baldwin Wallace at their own 34.
Baldwin Wallace at their own 34.
They're set to punt this one away.
Austin Smith to punt for Baldwin Wallace.
Connor Lucas back to return for the Cardinals.
Lucas to receive for Otterbein.
They should have some decent field position after this punt. And it was nearly blocked. It's away. Connor Lucas moves to his right. He makes the catch inside the 30. Tries to cut to the left, but can't quite get through. And gets out to the 29-yard line.
Ryan Stepp and Tyrone Brininger come out on the tackle.
So Otterbein will start from their own 29. 11:58 to go in the first half.
Return to the 29-yard line.
Baldwin Wallace still leads this one 14-0.
Otterbein football, first and 10.
Green will take this once more.
Yeah, he's in the gun. He's still got piles in there with him. He moves him to his left. 3 receivers to the left. 1 to the right. And he's going to hand this one to Piles. Piles has a hole. He breaks through. He's across the 40, across the 45, and he spins out of bounds.
Piles on the carry.
Right around the 47-yard line. So, again, a nice run from Piles.
Quite the duo we have here, Green and Piles. Used them on quite a few plays, especially in the last quarter.
Yeah, and you know, we tend to see a stable of backs for Otterbein, and it's really just been Piles here today as he's still out there with Green. They come out in the same formation with Piles to the right. And that was a false start.
Penalty marker before the snap.
That was right tackle for the Cardinals, who jumped early. That was Case Troyer, the right tackle. He's only a sophomore. He jumps early. Started every game this year for the Cardinals at right tackle. He's going to have a lot of experience next year.
42, first and 15.
And now it's going to be a first and 15, and Green will take the snap, looking to pass, throws it over the middle to Logan Stepp. Stepp makes a man miss, spins out of a tackle, and is dropped inside the 35, down to the 34. So Logan Stepp with a nice catch and a spin move to pick up a little extra yardage.
And I think that's what is what Otterbein is going to need to do if they're going to try and tie this game up.
A big 24-yard pass play there. And now they're going to go right back to Piles. Piles pops through a hole. And now he's over the 20. Inside the 20-yard line. So Piles avoided the pile and picked up a good chunk of yardage.
I saw what you did there, Jeff.
And he's inside the 20, so the Cardinals are in the red zone for the first time today, down to the 19. And
Baldwin Wallace making substitutions.
Yeah, they move some players around on the defense. Piles gets it again. He's into the secondary, inside the five, and he's into the end zone for an Otterbein touchdown. So John Piles, the key player on that drive, that's for sure. He runs it four times and picks up a nice chunk every time and rolls into the end zone from 18 yards out to get the Cardinals on the scoreboard.
And especially with that touchdown, the crowd finally has some energy back in them.
Yeah, crowd gets excited after that one. We've got the extra point coming from a Bass Cisse. And hopefully they'll cut this one down to just a one-score game. Ball is back. It's down. The kick is up.
Extra point by a Bass Cisse is
so
good.
It's going to make the score. Baldwin Wallace 14, Otterbein 7. So after two drives where the Cardinals didn't show too much life, they get a stop, and they get into the end zone.
I think Otterbein Cardinals are finally waking up.
Yeah, the offense definitely looked really good there. John Piles leading the way with a number of runs. He had a 16-yard run, an 18-yard run, and then the 18-yard touchdown run. So a very nice drive for John Piles.
Now it'll be up to the Cardinal defense to try and stop the next drive from Baldwin Wallace with Mogwin just having a variation of plays and hasn't been stopped on each drive.
Yeah, Mogwin, I mean, if Baldwin Wallace completes that little pullback in the flats play, they probably pick up another first down and keep it moving. But, you know, the pass was dropped by Blake, and it leads to an Otterbein touchdown. The Cardinals are getting ready to kick this one off, and they'll be kicking into the wind on this time. So we'll see if they go for a more squib-esque kick or if they're going to try a traditional one, try to punch it through the wind.
Joe Sanfilippo kicking off for Otterbein.
Filippo kicking off for Otterbein.
Yep, he's ready to kick this one away.
Adam Blake and Austin Smith to receive for Baldwin Wallace.
And they have Blake and Smith, two of the three running backs to return. This one is a short kick. It's going to be fielded at the 25-yard line by Blake, and he rolls out across the 35.
And Blake on the return for Baldwin Wallace.
Up to the 37. So kicking from left to right has been a struggle for both teams as they've surrendered
Drew Urban and Stephen
a very
Carter
nice starting
tackle.
Field position multiple times in this one.
Return to the 37, Baldwin Wallace football, first and 10.
First and 10 for Baldwin Wallace.
Starting this drive out at the 37-yard line. And they have the touchdown man, Isaac Reed, back in the backfield. So after the last two drives were Blake and Smith, this time it's Reed. Moglen checks the sideline for the play, now directs his line accordingly. Moves back in the gun, takes the snap, blitz comes, he throws it out, and the receiver falls down.
Catch is still good.
Yep, he makes the catch, but when your knee's down in college, your knee's down, so he didn't gain any yardage. He was right at the line of scrimmage. Again, Otterbein dodges the bullet. There's no one out there to cover him.
Right.
Second down and 10 from the 37-yard line for the Yellow Jackets as Moglen has Reed behind him in the gun. Two receivers to the right, and he's going to hand this one up the middle to Reed, and Reed plows forward out across the 40 to the 42. So he gains 5, and now it'll be a third down and 5.
And Nick Toledo come out on the tackle.
Isaac Reed, a rather shorter player, only standing about 5'8".
Yeah, you got some small guys out there on the field today. Their other back, Austin Smith's only 5'8 as well, and we know Connor Lucas is only 5'5". So.
And actually, Tyler Moglen's only 5'10".
Yeah, small quarterback like Drew Brees. He's got more mobility than Brees, that's for sure, but he's going to look to pass on 3rd and 5. Throws this one over the middle. The catch is made across the field.
Pass complete to Tommy Fuller.
And it's going to be another first down. That one was to Fuller again. Up to the 49 of the Cardinals.
Play games to the Otterbein 49. Baldwin Wallace football, 1st and 10.
And I'm afraid to say it, the drive for Baldwin Wallace is going same as before.
Yeah, it looked like they were going to have a chance to stop him on that third down, but they find an open receiver in Fuller, and he picks up the first as they moved again into Otterbein territory. Moglen is going to check the sideline for the play. Now he'll take the snap, fakes the handoff, looks to pass, throws it deep down the near side. He's got a man. The catch is made, and his receiver, Byron Cook, is down to the 2-yard line. And the Yellow Jackets have 2 rushing touchdowns so far, and they're probably going to look to make it a 3rd here from the 2.
If I were a betting man, yep, Isaac Reed.
Yeah, Isaac Reed takes the handoff, goes right through the middle into the end zone for a 2nd short rushing touchdown of the game. And that's going to get that touchdown right back from the Cardinals and push this lead back up to a 14-point game.
You know, I tell you, Jeff, it's going to take more than lucky breaks for the Cardinal defense to finally get a conversion.
Yeah, they've really not been able to do much stopping of this offense. Yeah. Ooh.
Kick was almost blocked.
I somewhat disagree with that call on that kick there. It looked wide left to me, but they say it's through the uprights and 21-7 is the score now.
Baldwin Wallace scoring drive, 5 plays, 63 yards, 2 minutes 17 seconds off the clock.
That kick looked wide right, but it's ruled good, and 21-7 is the score. With 8:23 to go here in the first half, and Otterbein can have a nice long drive here, get some points on the board, and try and take this one to halftime at 21-14. I think they'd be happy.
Absolutely.
Considering how that first quarter played out.
And if we were to go through in the history from the first quarter, I'd say Green needs to start passing a little bit more.
Yeah, they looked good. Or, you know, he's 5 of 6 now for 31 yards, and it's been a lot of John Pyles on the ground. He's got 71 yards rushing here in the first half, plus the touchdown. And we've got Hammond and Christian Johnson back to receive this kickoff. It's a line drive. And it's going to go back into the end zone for a touchback.
Kickoff goes through the end zone for a touchback.
So the Cardinals will bring this one out to their 20-yard line to start this drive. The offense huddles with the coaching staff. to get things straight. It's out to the 25-yard line. Excuse me.
First and 10, Otterbein at their own 25.
So they'll have 75 yards to go to get in the end zone here.
With 8:23.
Yep, 8:23 on the clock.
Green comes out with Piles to his right.
With two receivers to his left, two receivers to his right. Takes the shotgun snap, hands it to Piles over the left side. Piles breaks a tackle and is all the way out
John Piles
to the 34-yard line, so a 9-yard run on first down for Piles.
John Nischwitz and Jake Maurer on the tackle.
Brought down by Maurer.
9 yards to the 34, second down one.
I wouldn't be surprised if they go right back to him here, and that's exactly what they do. Piles up the middle. Short gain this time, not as
John
much room
Piles
as before, but he gains 3 yards, and that's enough for a first down.
Otterbein picks up a nice first down.
And Andy Schultz come out on the stop. 3 yards to the.
I'd like to see a little bit more variation
football, in first and 10.
Just the playbook from the Otterbein offense.
Yeah, but so far, the Yellow Jackets have really been unable to stop Piles, so why go away from him? And here,
fair enough.
Piles plows ahead again, out to the 40-yard line, a pickup of another 3 yards.
Piles on the carry.
And if you can get 3 yards on every play, you know, hey. We'll take it. You'll get in the end zone eventually.
Makes for a very long drive.
Jake
very long, but
Ian Harmon on the
successful
back.
In the end. And Piles has looked very good so far.
Second down, seven.
He's nearing 100 yards already. And he splits out wide to the left, and Green looks to pass. Now he's going to try and run it. He tucked that one down really early, and he gains
Kevin Green carries
40 yards. So a very generous spot by the officials. It didn't look like he got that far, but they're going to mark him out at the 44-yard line.
Yep. Oh, quite a generous spot from the refs.
4 yards.
That was an interesting play. He ignored the screen out to the left, was looking to throw to the right, and then pulled it down very quickly and tried to run. He didn't really have much room, but picked up 4 yards. And now they go with the hard count. He's going to change the play at the line. And they're going to look to pass. And there's no blocking at all. And
Kevin
he's sacked immediately. All the way back.
Sean Nischwitz.
At the 41, if they will mark him.
I'm sure Green is not happy about that one bit.
And it's a little surprising to me that they didn't decide to go with the run there with how much success Piles has had.
Mm-hmm.
There's
a long two to get for that first down, and they went to pass, and there was just no blocking up front, as now they're going to have to punt on fourth and 11. Now there's a flag on the play. Someone probably lined up offsides, and there's going to be a fair catch made at the 29-yard line.
Theodore Washington with a fair catch around the 29-yard line.
Probably
going
to get to re-punt this one.
Quite a bit of mixed emotions on the sideline for the Cardinals.
Yeah, they're seeing whether what the coach wants to do with this penalty. And it looks like now the officials are still talking. It looked like Coach Daup said, let's go ahead and take the kick. But the officials are conferring about something.
You know, we've seen very little from number 11, Julian Lowe, the slot receiver.
Yeah, Lowe only has 2 catches, I believe, in this game. And he's been, well, he's got 3 catches for 17 yards, so only 3 catches for Lowe, and he's been the OIC's leading receiver. So it's a little bit of a surprise that he's only got 3 receptions so far. And now finally.
Both sides on the defense.
The penalty was declined, and I'm not sure why it took so long, because it looked like Dalf told them immediately that he wanted to decline that penalty. And it's going to start the Yellow Jacket drive at their 29-yard line.
First and 10, Baldwin Wallace.
4 drives, 3 touchdowns and a punt. And it could have easily been 4 drives and 4 touchdowns. But Moglen will take the snap out of the gun, sends the receiver in motion, hands this one off up the middle. And that was Austin Smith again.
Austin Smith on the carry.
He's tackled at the 30-yard line for a gain of only 1 yard.
Excellent work by Smith to read that play.
Gain of a yard to the 30, second down, 9.
Comes up for only a yard that time, so it's going to bring up a second and 9 from the 30. And the Cardinals could really use a stop and a big drive to get back in this game. Because they will get the ball to start the second half. And Moglen calling out the play. He'll take the snap, looking to pass. He throws it to the far side, has a man, it's caught. Still fighting. And he actually loses a yard because he tried to continue fighting, and that's going to be about 2 yards short the first down.
Jordan Boniface and Stephen Carpenter on the stop.
Jordan Boniface and Stephen Carpenter
gain
with that
stop. Gain of 8 to the 38, third down 1.
Gain of 8.
Third and a long one here. And this could be a big stop for the Cardinals. But we'll see what they do. As Baldwin Wallace looks to the sideline again for the play, and now Moglen changes it at the line.
Once again, we have the one clap and then look.
And here's the second clap. There's the snap. Hands off up the middle, and they have the first down. That's Smith out to the 42-yard line. And Smith's been very reliable
Austin
picking
Smith
up
on the carry.
1 or 2 yards every time he touches the ball.
Certainly.
So we're about to dip under 4 minutes to go in this first half. The Yellow Jackets continue to lead 21-7 over the Otterbein Cardinals.
Still in the Yellow Jackets 40. If the Cardinals could stop them there, that could turn very favorable.
Yeah, if they can come up with a big defensive stop, they haven't really been able to do it all game. Now they send a receiver out behind Moglen. That's George, and they're going to hand it off to him. Now they're going to hand it off to Smith up the middle, and Smith gains about 6 yards on first down.
Austin Smith carries. Nick Toledo and Stephen Carpenter on the tackle.
Nearing midfield once again.
Gain of 6 to the 48, second down 4.
48-yard line. Now Baldwin Wallace content to run some clock here as they want this to be their final drive of the half. Moglen with two backs flanking him in the backfield. Sends one in motion over to the right, and Moglen pulls it back, keeps it himself, and fights forward to the 49-yard line of Otterbein. It's going to bring up a third down and 1.
Will Brennan and Dalton Jarvis on the tackle.
And now Baldwin Wallace goes quickly again. They take the quick snap, hand it off up the middle to Smith, and Smith is met near the line of scrimmage. It's going to depend on the spot. It'll depend where they spot him. And he's very close to the first down, and now we're going to call a timeout for the measurement.
Officials timeout for a measurement.
It looks like he got it. To me, it looks like he got it. They needed to get to the 48. Looks like the nose of the football is right near the 48-yard line. Even if they didn't get it, I imagine the Yellow Jackets would be willing to go for this on fourth and less than a foot. But the nose of the football is right on the marker, and that's going to be a first down. So it will continue this drive with 2:27 to go. The first half.
Line of scrimmage, you got to buy 48.
Still 2:18 left in the quarter.
Yeah, as the Yellow Jackets have two of their timeouts left, and they'll look to work this one into the end zone. To be the final drive of the half. Moglen looks to pass. He's going to throw it over the middle. And the catch, there's no catch. It's on the ground. So they'll roll an incomplete pass.
Tyler Moglen's pass intended for Tommy Fuller, incomplete.
That pass intended for Tommy Fuller.
Yeah, Steve Carpenter jumped that one and nearly got the interception. And it was Fuller, as you mentioned, Will, who was the one who was the intended receiver. Moglen directs his lineman with the play. And from the gun, he sends the receiver in motion, stops right behind Moglen, who hands this one off up the middle to Smith. Smith gains about 6 yards.
Smith with the carry.
And it's going to be a third down and four from the 42-yard line of Otterbein.
Carpenter combined on the stop.
Yeah, no problem. We got the
under 2 minutes to go in the first half.
6 yards to the 42, third down, four.
Third down and four.
Still enough time if the Cardinals can turn this over.
Yeah, it would be crucial for them to get a stop without allowing any points here. They don't want to fall any further behind. Moglen taking his good time here. He's going to call out the play.
Bailey goes to the back.
And he takes the snap, rolls out to his left, throws it. He's got a man. They got a first down, and he's shoved out of bounds. Down at the 33-yard line.
Pass complete to Tommy Fuller.
So bad on all aspects for the Cardinals. They get the first down. They get out of bounds to stop the clock, and they're going
to
continue this drive. And they're nearing field goal range now as the wind will be at their back.
Baldwin-Wallace football, first and 10.
I think like last week's game is going to take a talking to from the coach to get this Cardinal defense on point.
Yeah, last week the defense struggled in the first half as Otterbein trailed 15-10 at halftime, and they came out in the second half and got four consecutive turnovers that led to the offensive breakout. And here Moglen will look to run it himself. Might have been a broken play, but Moglen makes the best of it and dives down to the 25-yard line for a gain of 7 yards.
Dalton Jarvis on the stop.
Jarvis on the stop.
7 yards to the 25.
They continue to let the clock run here. So under 35 seconds to go in this first half. Moglen takes the snap, hands it to Smith up the middle, and Smith is tackled right at the 20-yard line.
Austin Smith with the carry.
It's going to be a first down, so it stops the clock momentarily at 40 seconds. Now the clock runs.
Baldwin-Wallace football, first and 10.
I don't know why they're not taking any timeouts here and why they continue to run the ball, but they must be that confident they're going to get this one into the end zone. Moglen rolls to his left, looks to pass, looking for the end zone, floats it up. Has a man, and the catch is made by the receiver, Trevor George. He makes it one-handed as he fends off the defensive back, falling into the end zone. And, well, Baldwin-Wallace did just what they wanted to do. They
absolutely
ate up a big chunk of the clock and got in the end zone. They look like they're going to extend this lead to three touchdowns with 20.5 to go in the first half.
As much as I hate to see it, that was an excellent catch.
Yeah, he comes down with a one-handed grab in the corner. And now the extra point is up, and it is good. So that's going to make the score. Baldwin-Wallace 28, Otterbein 7, with only 20 seconds to go here in this first half.
Otterbein 7.
And last week they trailed by five. This week it's 21, unless they can get a big play here going into the half, but it doesn't look promising for the Cardinals.
Well, as there's essentially no time left in the half, Cardinals go back to the locker room.
They'll get the return, and if they can break a big return, you know, maybe Coach Tapp will decide to go for a few shots to the end zone, but if they don't get much on this return, I would not expect
Riley
them
Jones
to come out too aggressively. They will be receiving the ball to start the second half, but down three touchdowns, the defense really needs to pick it up if they're going to get back in this game. Kick is away. It's going to be fielded by Hammond. He makes the catch near the 3-yard line, and he makes a move. There's a block, but Yeah, he only gets out to the 12-yard line, so I'd expect a knee to come here from Kevin Green and
Ryan
the Cardinals.
Steph and Robert Andronia.
Hammond is just trying to make something happen and couldn't really get it going as he's brought down at the 12-yard line. And now the Cardinals will most likely take a knee to get us to halftime.
Otterbein football, first and 10.
Yeah, they're going to come out in the victory formation, although at this point that's not really the cause of this one. Just want to get us into halftime, and there's the knee. Baldwin Wallace won't take a timeout, and that's going to bring us to halftime. So after 30 minutes of play, the Baldwin Wallace Yellow Jackets lead the Otterbein Cardinals by a score of 28-7.
Halftime score, Baldwin Wallace
here, at halftime, and we're going to have some halftime statistics and updates for you after a break. And we're here in lovely Westerville, Ohio. As it's been a difficult day for the Cardinals. So they would trail in this one 28-7. And
just give me a nice
the coaching staff continues to talk to the team on the field, not letting them go to the locker room here. But
at the same time, the band comes onto the field for the halftime show.
And we're going to take a quick break here, and we'll be back with some halftime statistics at Memorial Stadium.
Oh, God, I am terrible at this.
We're back here at Memorial Stadium in Otterbein University in lovely Westerville, Ohio. The Otterbein Cardinals trail at halftime. The Baldwin-Wallace Yellow Jackets, 28-7. And we're going to have some halftime statistics for you. So, Will, what do you got?
Well, looking at the stats from halftime, we've got Baldwin-Wallace having almost double just about every stat. We've got 115 rushing yards for Baldwin-Wallace compared to Otterbein's 86. We've got 209 passing yards for Baldwin-Wallace compared to Otterbein's 41. Of course, we have three touchdowns for Baldwin-Wallace compared to our one. And more rushing yards for Moglen and Reed and Smith than Piles and Green combined.
The one thing that does stand out for me, though, is that Piles has those eight carries for 86 yards. So while the team is not doing great, he himself is having a very good individual performance as he's nearing 100 yards in just the first half.
No, John Piles is doing is having an excellent game today.
And looking at some of the scores from around the conference, Ohio Northern in the second quarter leads Muskingum 21-0. Just before halftime, Mount Union is beating Wilmington 56-0. Our game, of course, 28-7, Baldwin-Wallace leads at the half. At the half, John Carroll leads Capital 28-0. And the final game that is going on right now
Otterbein to receive the third quarter is
Heidelberg.
Riley Jones.
With 36 seconds left in the first half, Heidelberg leads Marietta by a score of 63-14.
Holy cow.
With 36 seconds to go in the first half.
I want to check back in on that game later. That is a very high-scoring game for only half.
We'll have to see exactly how ugly that one's going to get, but 63 points at halftime, and Mount Union with 56, so got some very high scores in the OAC today.
And as we come back into the second half for this game, Baldwin-Wallace kicks off.
As Hammond receives that punt down around the 10 and takes it back out to the 25-yard line, marking him down right at the 26. And that's where Otterbein will start this drive. It'll be important for them to get some momentum and get a big scoring drive together here.
I'm sure John Piles, who has had a great game today, we'll be back onto the field.
You'd have to imagine that we're going to see a lot of John Piles here as far as Otterbein offense goes in this second half as he comes out onto the field with Kevin Green in the shotgun. He moves over now to Green's right as we got a split receiver set. Green looks to pass on first down, throws it quickly, and it's dropped by Logan Stepp. Hit him right in the chest, and he couldn't hold it just inside the 30-yard line and bring up a second and 10.
And from this first play alone, we might see a change in play style after the half.
The problem with that play there is, you gain about 4 yards if he catches it, but now you got to go second and 10, and it really takes the run out of the equation for the Cardinals. It's been their strength all game. Green rolls to his left, looks to pass, now tries to come back and is sacked from the backside all the way back to the 19-yard line, so a loss of 7 yards on the sack.
And that's
just how quickly the momentum can shift. You get a drop pass and a sack, and all of a sudden you've got a third down and 19 from the 19, and it's
quite a vocal audience here today.
They're getting
sure
a little
they're
ready.
Happy.
And it's going to be a wide open empty backfield set for Green. Five wide, three to his right, two to his left. He's going to look to pass. Throws it short to Julian Lowe, who makes a move and is pushed out of bounds at the 25-yard line for just a gain of 6 yards. Lowe's fourth catch of the game. But it's going to bring up a punting situation for the Cardinals.
6 to the 25, fourth down and 11.
Yep, Sanfilippo will kick this off.
He gets the snap, boots this one away. It's a very nice one. It's fielded inside the 30 by Austin Smith.
Brought down to about the 35-yard line.
Yeah, he doesn't get much on the return, but Otterbein's defense has been unable to stop this Baldwin-Wallace offense here today, and it's going to need to change if they have any hope of getting back into this ball game.
Now, we saw from the first drive from the Cardinals a heavy pass offense, and we saw that the Yellow Jackets switched up their play style just according to me. I wonder if it'll be the same for the defense.
We'll see if the Baldwin-Wallace changes anything here. They continue to do that hard count and check the sideline. As Moglen adjusts the play at the line and hands this one off. No, he keeps it himself, and he's got some space to run. He makes a man miss, and he's all the way out to the 47-yard line. So big run on first down brings up another first down for Moglen. And they're all the way out now to the 48-yard line. So a 12-yard run for Moglen on first down. It'll bring up another first down. The Yellow Jackets remain in the gun. There's three receivers to the right of Moglen on the near side. One to the top, to his left. He takes the snap, looks to pass. Throws it over the middle. Catch is made at the 40-yard line.
Connor Moglen's pass complete to Mike Wagner.
It was Mike Wagner at the 40.
Drew Urban and Jordan Shell on the tackle.
And that is another first down. Another gain of 12.
12 to the Otterbein 40.
So two straight 12-yard completions.
Baldwin-Wallace football, first and 10.
Move it right down into Otterbein territory. Moglen calls out the play at the line, backs up into the gun. He'll take the snap, hands this one off up the middle, and that's Blake breaking through into the secondary.
Adam Blake carries.
And that is another first down.
That was Moglen faking the pass up to the left of the screen.
Yeah, fake the screen out to the left, handed it off to Blake up the middle. He takes it down 14 yards to the 26-yard line. And now they motion Smith, and it's a quarterback keeper. As they had Blake line up at quarterback, he runs through a tackle and then is pushed out of bounds.
Adam Blake on the carry.
For another first down.
Brought inside the Cardinal 10.
All the way down to the 12-yard line. So four plays on this drive and four gains of over 10 yards and four first downs.
We
could get one more first down at the 2-yard line. And here's the handoff, making a man miss, but going down is the receiver who comes in for the handoff that time.
Austin Smith with the carry.
That was Austin Smith. He made a man fall down, but then the rest of the defense caught up to him, and that's their first play that hasn't gone for a first down on this drive as they lose 4 yards.
Will Brett on the tackle for Otterbein.
So after two plays from the Wildcat, or in this case the Wild Jacket.
Yellow Jacket?
Yeah, the Wild Yellow Jacket.
The Wild Yellow, all right.
They go back to a more traditional set with Moglen, and he fakes the handoff, looks to throw back. There's a flag on the play, and Blake has the reception, goes into
Kelly
the end
Parker
zone.
On the play.
But there's a flag on the play, and chances are it's holding. That's exactly what it is. So the touchdown will be negated. That's going to bring up a second and 24.
I was holding on number 52 of the offense.
He was not happy with the call. He had some words with the official as his teammate was racing in for the end zone.
Second down, 24.
The second and 24 back at the 26-yard line. They can pick up a first down at the 2. And Otterbein is really hoping that that does not happen. There's some confusion with the officials. as they are trying to get the play clock reset, and there it goes.
Please reset the game clock. Game clock 11:05. Thank you.
And they're going to put 24 seconds back on the clock. I'm not sure what the issue there was, but the clock must not have stopped after that last play, and now it's 11:05 to go in the third quarter. It's a second and 24. Moglen looks to pass, throws it deep over the middle. He's got a man, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown. He ran right through the defense, makes the catch, and goes in untouched. That's Jordan LeVarrett, the freshman, getting his first action of the day. Makes the grab, rolls right into the end zone.
Pass from Tyler Moglen to Jordan LeVarrett.
So 10:59 left in this third quarter. And
attempting the extra point.
It's
Tyler Moglen holding.
Now about to be a 35-7 game here in favor of the Yellow Jackets as the snap is back, the kick is up, and it's good. So 35-7, just under 11 minutes to go in the third quarter. There's a flag on the play, but it'll most likely be assessed on the kickoff. And the Cardinals are in a big hole now. They trail this one by 28 points, and they have been unable to stop the Yellow Jackets the entire game. It was an offsides on the Cardinals, and it will be declined. So Otterbein will go back to return the kick. It's going to be Tyler Hammond and Kristen Johnson.
And with just under 11 minutes in the third quarter, Otterbein is going to have to pull something from deep within the playbook.
Yeah, they're going to have to.
Tyler Moglen.
They're going to have to get in the end zone here, and then they're going to have to do what they did last week and force four consecutive turnovers.
You think it will take that much, Jeff?
That's what it's going to take.
All right, then.
To get back in this game. And there has not been a turnover in this game. And the kick is away. Hammond comes up to field it at the 12. He moves it back towards the middle of the field. He tries to cut through some blockers. And he's dragged down at the 23, and there's a flag on the backside of the play.
Howard Dover on the tackle.
So this one might be coming back.
Holding number 99, return team.
Yep, it's a hold on the Cardinals. So it's going to back them up 10 yards.
Holden Wallace scoring drive, 6 plays, 64 yards, 2 minutes, 29 seconds.
All the way back to the 14.
26-yard pass, Moglen to LeVarrett.
Took Baldwin Wallace only 6 plays to score on that last drive. They've been very efficient moving the football in this game. So the Cardinals are going to have to really get it together. Piles in the backfield with Green. Fakes the handoff to Piles. Green throws over the middle. And they're going to say the catch is made, a sliding catch there by Connor Lucas at the 25-yard line. So that's just enough for a first down. Baldwin Wallace was trying to say it hit the turf. The officials felt that Lucas secured that one.
11-yard gain. Otterbein football, first and 10.
Green with Piles in the gun. He's going to hand it to Piles up the middle. Piles moves around a tackler and is out across the 30 to the 31. 6 yards on first down for John Piles. He's up to 90 yards on the game and very close to a big 100-yard day for Piles.
Yeah, Piles has been crucial for this Cardinal offense.
He's really been the only one who showed up.
Mm-hmm.
Green from the gun. Takes the snap. They got a free play as a man jumped. It's a quick pass over the middle to Julian Lowe. Gains 6 yards to the 36. They'll probably just take the play since it's only going to be a 5-yard penalty anyway.
Tackled by Tyler Burdoff.
They gain out to the 36. It'd be a first down.
Offsides defense number 36. That penalty decline result play is a first down.
The play picks up the first down. One more yard than they would have had otherwise. And it gives Julian Lowe another catch. his fifth of the game.
Ottobine football at their own 36.
Pyle stays in the backfield. We haven't really seen any of the other backs that they have today. As Green looks to pass again. He's looking deep, throws one deep over the middle, and overthrows Lowe.
Kevin Green's pass.
Who had some space to the inside, but Green overthrew him deep. And it's going to bring up a second down and 10.
Second and 10 at the Cardinals 36.
You know, I like seeing the Cardinal offense having more of a passing game this half. But you're not going to have touchdowns with shoddy passes like that.
Yeah, he overthrew Lowe by a good 5 yards, and Lowe had some space if he could have hit him. Let's see if they go back to the run. If they're going to stick with the pass, they are going to hand it off to Pyles up the middle, and Pyles is ahead, very close to the first down. It looks like he's got it. So an 11-yard gain for Pyles, and he goes over 100 yards on the day.
Pyles doing an excellent job finding that gap in the defensive line.
Not a real big guy, but he's working his way through there and using that to his advantage. This time he only gains about 2 yards on first down.
Pyles carries.
Pyles listed at 5'8", 190 pounds. So a lot of little guys in this game today.
Two to the 49, second down, 8.
It'll be a second and 8 from the 49-yard line. 9 minutes to go in the third quarter. Green moves Pyles to his left.
Three receivers on top of the screen.
Yeah, surveys the defense, points something out to Pyles. Now he changes the play. Takes the snap, looks to pass, throws it quickly over the middle. The catch is made by Julian Lowe.
Kevin Green's pass complete to Julian Lowe.
And Lowe is out to the 42-yard line for another Ottobein first down.
Theodore Washington on the stop.
So the offense is really, all day has only been Lowe and Pyles. It's really all they've gotten since only one other receiver has a catch, or now two with Connor Lucas on this drive. And Green is the only other one with a rush attempt. He's going to look to throw deep over the middle. He's got a man that's low, low, makes the grab inside the 5, down to the 2.
Excellent catch from Julian Lowe.
Yeah, Lowe with a very nice catch, a perfectly thrown ball that time from Kevin Green. He missed him earlier. That time he hits him. And Lowe is all the way down to the 2-yard line, and he's approaching 100 yards receiving on the day.
Cordell Quinn on the tackle for Baldwin Wallace.
And we'll see if they give the Pyles to let him get his second rushing touchdown of the day. Green calls out directions at the line. He's going to look to throw it. Throws it over the middle. The ball is tipped, and there is no flag. It's just going to fall incomplete.
Pass intended for Logan Stepp, incomplete.
I think there was just a mistiming on that last play. As
that ball looked like it got batted somewhere in the line.
Second and goal at the Baldwin Wallace 3.
I'm surprised they didn't give it to Pyles. He's been consistently picking up chunks of yardage in this game, and they only have 3 to go.
No, he would be the perfect person for this.
And now Lowe is going to motion over to the right. There's some confusion on the Ottobein offense as now Lowe runs back to the left.
Penalty marker before the snap.
And there's a flag on the play. It's looking like it's going to be a false start on the Cardinals. And
false start.
Two receivers. Both Julian Lowe as well as Kevin Green are over on the sideline.
And that'll be a false start for number 56, Jacob Schaefer, the center.
That's his third penalty of the game.
Second down goal, Ottobein.
And there was just a lot of confusion on that play as to who was supposed to be where and when they were moving. And hope they've got everything figured out for this one. It's a second and 8. Second and goal from the 8. Green takes the snap. He's going to look to pass. He's pressured. Hit as he throws, the catch is made, but back down to the 2-yard line.
Kevin Green's pass complete to Joe Beatty.
That was Joey Beatty, his first catch of the game, but it gets him the 5 yards back down to the two.
5 yards to the 3 yard line. Third down.
So,
well, back to the two. Let's see if the Cardinals can not have as much confusion on this try.
Well, they got a third down and goal here.
And third and goal. And I just can't understand why Piles hasn't gotten the ball in this situation. As Lowe goes in motion to the right, he's going to roll out right, look for Lowe. He's got him open. He hits him, and that's an Otterbein touchdown. Baldwin Wallace just didn't have enough men over there on that side to make up for Lowe in the motion. He came from left to right and just snuck underneath for the touchdown. So the two guys who've been moving the offense, Lowe as well as Piles, now each have a touchdown on the day.
And that's really what the Cardinal offense is going to have to do for most of this game if they're going to bring this to a tie or even to try and win this.
And it's going to be up to that defense to force some turnover. As the freshman Cisse, he kicks it. And it is through the uprights, making the score Baldwin Wallace 35, Otterbein 14. 7:02 to go here in the third quarter at Memorial Stadium.
And the cheerleaders are on the field.
Yeah, it's interesting. They always have some kind of celebration they do after every touchdown.
This one looking like a massive chicken fight of sorts.
Yeah, and interesting tradition here.
6 yards, 3 minutes, 50 seconds.
Anything to get the morale boosted. As Otterbein still trails by two touchdowns.
Yeah, it's 35-14. They're down 21 points in this one, so it's going to be up to that defense to force some turnovers, get some stops, and hope to get back in this game. Otterbein will be kicking off. It'll be Sanfilippo.
Joe Sanfilippo kicking off for Otterbein.
To kick it off. Got
Adam Blake and Austin Smith.
We've got Smith and Blake back to return for the Yellow Jackets.
Looks like the ball fell down.
Yeah, ball falls off the tee, so if it falls off one more time, they'll have to have someone hold it. It's gotten fairly windy here today. Sanfilippo readies his men. Runs up to hit this one away. It's a line drive. It'll be fielded down at the 2 yard line by Smith. And now there's a flag on the play that came down inside the 15, and he's
Austin
out to the
Smith
20.
For Baldwin Wallace, penalty marker on the play.
So this one might be all the way back inside the 10 yard line.
Peyton Vanderkoy.
Walking back, number 20, returning. 10 yard penalty. First down, Baldwin Wallace.
So it's a block in the back on Baldwin Wallace, and it's going to back them up. They already have two drives for touchdowns starting at the 6, so they've been here before in this one.
It'll take the Cardinal defense to try and push Baldwin Wallace.
The ball is marked at the 8.5 yard line, the official says.
Baldwin Wallace football, first and 10.
The first and 10 from inside the 10, the third time today they've started inside the 10. And there's the snap. The handoff goes right up the middle to Reed. We haven't seen too much. We saw him early, and he got two touchdowns, but they went to Smith, and they went to Blake a lot in the later portion of that second quarter and the start of the third quarter. Brings up a 2nd and 6 from the 13-yard line. And Otterbein really wants to get a stop here as it'll force Baldwin Wallace to punt into the wind. They're going to hold him into the wind for the next 6:20 to go in this third. As Moglen takes the snap, looks to pass, it's a screen out to the far side. One man out there, and the one-on-one play is made. So they gain about a yard out to the 15. Boniface gets out there and makes the tackle. It's going to be a third down and 4.5. They need to get to the 18.5 yard line to get this first down. Moglin has three receivers to his right. Motions Reed to his right. Takes the snap. Rolls out to the right. Looks for his man. He hits him. He's wide open. And he's out of bounds across the 30 out to the 31. That's Mike Wagner with the catch. So, again, the defense fails to stop him. And Baldwin Wallace will continue to move forward. Out of bounds at the 31. Bringing up a first and 10 for the Yellow Jackets. Moglin directs his lineman, giving him the play. He backs up into the gun. Moves Reed to his right. Takes the snap, fakes the handoff to Reed, throws it quick out in the flat, and it's off the hands of his intended receiver.
Intended for Trevor George.
That was George. And he was tackled immediately, but the ball came out. So, incomplete pass.
Second and 10 at the 31.
That was excellent coverage by number 28, Jordan Shell, who stopped that pass.
Yeah, Shell was all over him. He saw that one out in the flat. They've run that play a few times, and Shell was ready for it. Second and 10 from the 30. And it's going to be a free play as Baldwin Wallace throws this one deep. It's overthrown, but it's an offsides on the Cardinals. It's going to be a second down and 5.
You can see the Cardinal defense jumping at Moglin's claps.
We still really haven't gotten fully comfortable with how they run that offense over there. So they're going to have a tougher time of stopping them as it's up to the 36 now.
Second and 5.
Just under 5 minutes left on the quarter.
Otterbein's time continues to run as they're down 3 touchdowns. They'll need to get stops. The receiver motioned behind Moglin. They hand it off to Reed up the middle, and he's going to go all the way to the end zone. He just runs it right up the middle, and no one touches him as he takes that one a good 64 yards to the end zone to really put a dagger in this Otterbein defense. It was just a straight handoff right up the middle, and the Red Seas parted. Nobody touched him as he rolls 64 yards to the end zone.
Well said, Jeff.
Joe Simonis attempting the extra point.
They really bottled Reed up. Hadn't done much to this point. He did have the two short touchdown runs, but now he's got that long one to his credit. The extra point's up and good. So that makes the score. Baldwin Wallace 42, Otterbein 14 with 4:40 to go here in the third quarter.
You know, Jeff, I cannot have any idea of what is going on through Coach Daub's mind.
Well, he cannot be very happy with his defense today. They have one stop.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. They have one stop the entire game, and it came on a drop pass that would have picked up a first down. So the defense has not had a good day at all.
Now, the last drive by the Cardinal offense did result in a touchdown.
Yeah, they had a nice drive. The offense hasn't played too poorly today, but the defense has just not given them any help at all.
Riley Jones kicking off for Baldwin Wallace. Speedy Hammond and Christian Johnson back for Otterbein.
Hammond and Johnson wait around the 10-yard line to return this kick, and this one is well up in the air again, and it's going to be fielded at the 20-yard line by Hammond, and he's hit hard. Out across the 25, out to the 26. So even though they field it up at the 20, they can't get much going. And kicking in this direction has been tough for everyone. These punters, and for Otterbein anyway, Baldwin Wallace has not punted.
Mm-hmm.
Their kickoffs have been short. They had the one that go out of bounds earlier going in this direction. Now the Otterbein offense back out on the field, and we'll see if they get John Piles the ball some more. As Green from the gun sends Piles out to the left, fakes the screen to him, and he's bottled up. The ball comes out. It looks like it was recovered by one of the Otterbein linemen.
Recovered by Otterbein.
And at this point in the game, Baldwin Wallace is just going off of their momentum.
Yeah, and you know, up by four touchdowns, you can afford to just bring some pressure and gamble on defense. You don't really need to be too worried, as they've got this game well in control. As
Ryan Bickle recovered.
Green was collapsed upon, 14. And the ball came out, but one of the Otterbein linemen
was able to pick that one up.
Green stays in the gun with Piles to his right. Takes the snap. He's looking to pass. He avoids the pressure, and he's still rolling. He tries to throw this one up, and very nearly intercepted. As he threw that one into double coverage. He was going for Joe Beatty, and it went between the hands of two Baldwin Wallace defenders.
Yep, nearly picked off by Baldwin Wallace number 27, Tyrone Brenninger.
Third and 15 at the 22.
Brings up a third and 15, so immediately following that long Baldwin Wallace touchdown drive, Otterbein is in danger of going three and out yet again. Kevin Green gets the play with Piles to his right, two receivers to both sides. Green goes with the hard count, takes the snap, looking to pass. Throws it deep over the middle, has a man, and yep, there's going to be pass interference. He was looking for Logan Stepp, and Stepp would have had the catch, but the defender got there early and pushed him in the back. So Otterbein's going to pick up the first down.
I'm sure there'll be pass interference on number 9, Brock Hull.
So Otterbein catches a break there, as they really didn't want to go three and out again.
Pass interference on defense, number 9, 15-yard penalty, previous spot, first down.
Big first down, and it was a very nice throw from Green. It was right to Stepp that time. He hit him in stride. It just, the defender came in and hit him in the back early.
Yeah, Hull definitely had his arms all around Stepp. No way of actually having a clean catch for that one.
Brings up a first and 10 out from the 37. Green surveys the defense, takes the snap, looks to pass. Throws it deep over the middle, and this one's intercepted. Now they're going to say it hit the turf. There's a sliding, what looked like an interception made by Hayden Heelshorn, but it is ruled incomplete, and Julian Lowe was not even looking for that pass, so a little bit of a miscommunication there between the receiver and the quarterback.
You know, Jeff, you were talking about lucky breaks. That's two in a row for Cardinals.
Yeah, the Cardinals starting to get some breaks here. It's just that defensive side of the ball, they haven't been able to get anything in their favor.
Yeah, just zoom fast enough that, like, it's not going to make people watching.
And Kevin Green surveys the defense again. Calls out a new play at the line. Two on the play clock. Takes the snap. Throws it quickly over the middle. That's Julian Lowe with the catch. And he's close to a first down. Gain of 9.
Tackle by Theodore Washington.
It'll be a tackle by Theodore Washington for the Yellow Jackets.
And I would imagine this is a time when they give the ball to Piles on a 3rd and 1.
You would hope they would give the ball to Piles on a 3rd and 1.
It would make some sense.
The Yellow Jacket sideline being very vocal. Sure trying to cause confusion.
Yeah, they're trying to get their defense into a big stop here. Screen moves Piles to his left. It's going to be a quick pass to Beatty. Beatty makes the catch, puts two arms around the ball as he's hit, and gets across midfield to the 49 for a first down.
And Sean Dishwitz.
So they use low and Piles as a distraction there and go to Beatty. They pick up a nice 4 yards for the first down. Green to pass again. Throws it out to Step. Step tries to sidestep a guy and makes it forward to about the 39-yard line. No pun intended there.
Howard Dover and Jaylen Brown come out on the tackle.
Almost thought there was going to be holding on the yellow jacket defense there.
Yeah, they were on Step early, but he makes the catch. Gains 8 yards. And Green takes the snap, throws out to the left. Julian Lowe gets 2 feet in before he's pushed out of bounds. Inside the 35 to the 34, and you got to wonder, where has this offense been all first half?
Where was Julian Lowe the entire first quarter?
Yeah, comes up with 3 catches for only 17 yards in that first half, and now he's making all the catches. Is Green to pass again. Looking deep, throws late, but Logan Step, he comes down, and the ball comes out as they hit the turf. It looked like he was going to make a very nice catch over the middle, but in traffic, he's hit, and the turf knocks the ball out as he comes to the ground.
You know, Jeff, I cannot blame this offense today. They're playing an excellent game, Low, Step, and John Piles.
Yeah, the offense took them a little while to get going in that first half. And unfortunately, Baldwin Wallace was able to build up a lead. But the offense hasn't looked too bad. They haven't turned the ball over yet. And, you know, they've been moving it pretty successfully.
Slowly, but successfully.
Yeah, they've got 2 touchdowns. They're driving for a third. And there's a throw, and this one is nearly intercepted. As Green was hit as he threw, it was high. It bounced off the hands of Lowe. And there was a diving attempt from one of the secondary defenders of the Yellow Jackets, and it's through his hands and into the turf.
Third and 10 at the 34.
It's going to bring up a third down and 10 from the 34-yard line, and at this point, it's 4-down territory all the way. Be no reason to punt down here. Zotterbein goes with 2 receivers to each side, and Piles behind Green, and now there's another false start. And this offensive line has been really cutting their momentum all game. And he's going to be lifted. You don't see that too often, but the right tackle, Case Troyer, with another false start, and he's immediately lifted for a backup. So I guess Coach Depp has had enough of that. It's going to be a 3rd and 15 from the 39. They carry that same formation. Green looking to pass. He throws deep, and it's overthrown. He was looking for Lowe on the near side. It overthrows everybody, and Green is slow to get up as he was hit again on that throw.
Looked like a case of missed timing on that play as Julian Lowe turned around way after the ball had sailed above him.
Yeah, and, you know, Green had to throw that one as he was getting pressured, and he just threw it up there hoping Lowe would make a break on it, but he didn't turn around in time to see it.
4th and 15.
And they're going to go for it here.
4th and 15.
5 wide receivers, and this might be another pooch punt, but, you know, at this point, you're down by a lot of points, and they're going to pass it. Green has a man open, and he overthrew him. He had a man open behind the defense. He was Joey Beatty, and that's the second time he's had an open receiver but overthrown him, and it's going to be a turnover on downs.
Wallace holds on downs, takes over possession of the football. 1st and 10 at their own 39.
The unfortunate there for the Cardinals is they had a man and Joey Beatty open beyond the defense, but Lowe just overthrew him.
Baldwin Wallace will take over the ball at their own 39.
Baldwin Wallace has it now, and I'm guessing we're just going to see a lot more running. As they look to burn the clock. They've got Smith in the backfield, and now it's going to be a pass, and it's caught. So they do exactly the opposite of what I thought they would.
Nope.
They go to the receiver, Tommy Fuller, who makes the catch down along the near sideline across midfield out to the 44-yard line.
Baldwin Wallace's offensive coordinator doing an excellent job of mixing up both run and pass plays.
Yeah, he's really just completely controlled his Otterbein defense all game. They motion the receiver into the backfield. And they fake the handoff to Blake, throwing it deep. And the catch is made at the 1 yard line. And that was number 12, Robbie Plagans, I believe, with that reception.
Chad Steinwalks on the reception for the Yellow Jackets.
Chad Steinwalks, number 17. Another freshman making a big catch all the way down to the 1 yard line.
Gains to the Cardinals 2.
And as the third quarter comes to a wrap, we can only hope that not too much more damage comes in the fourth.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to go from the Wildcat here as they've got Smith in the backfield to take this snap. Probably just going to try and pile this one right up the middle. He's going for it. He dives towards the end zone, and the ball came out apparently. And we'll see who has it.
Ball carrier.
Right on the goal line. This is going to be the last play of the third quarter. They're sorting out who has the ball. The referees confer.
Zach Davis and Joe Ifelice on the tackle.
It would appear that Baldwin Wallace recovered.
The ball was fumbled forward into the end zone, recovered by the offense for a touchdown. Baldwin Wallace.
And that will be a touchdown for Baldwin Wallace after the fumble.
15 seconds. Thank you.
So it will not be the last play of the third quarter. The fumble comes on the goal line and rolls into the end zone and is recovered by Baldwin Wallace. So that's yet another score.
Well, Jeff, do you want to check up on the other games?
Hasn't been too much of an update going on here. Mount Union continues to lead Wilmington 56-0. Heidelberg, start of the third quarter, still up 63-14 as the extra point is up. And it's wide left, so
wide to the left.
1 point less that Otterbein has to worry about. John Carroll leads 41-0. Baldwin Wallace leads this one 48-14. With 16 seconds to go in the third quarter. And at this point, it's a matter of pride for this defense. They have not gotten, they haven't forced a punt all game. They haven't forced a turnover. And they're just being embarrassed, quite frankly.
Mm-hmm.
It's 48-14 through three quarters of play against a team who's a good team, but we anticipated a much tighter matchup than this.
Certainly, with both teams coming into this game with even records.
1 minute, 9 seconds off the clock. Fumble recovered in the end zone.
And similar three-game winning streaks. And Otterbein having won the last three matchups with Baldwin Wallace.
Do you think maybe the Cardinals underestimated Baldwin Wallace?
I don't know. You know, I can't imagine that they would have, considering that they're a team that they're on even footing with at 4-2. And 4-1 in the conference, so.
They just have a Cardinal defense that.
Yep. The defense was just not motivated today. Not motivated to go out and get stops. This one's kicked away. It's going to be fielded by Hammond at the 19. He tries to come back across the field to the right, and he's hit hard at the 24. So Otterbein will start their next drive.
Brett Zupancic and Tyro Brenninger combine on the stop.
And an update from men's soccer. It appears that Otterbein men's soccer is having more success today than the football team, as they're in overtime right now, tied 2-2 against Baldwin Wallace. Men are having a pretty good season. They're at 8-5-2 and 3-2-1 in the OAC, and so hopefully they can pull out a big win. As Otterbein back on the field. Green looks to pass. He steps up. He's going deep over the middle. He's got a man, and the catch is made right across the 40-yard line to Connor Lucas.
Tackled by Brock Hull.
That may be the last play of the quarter, and it will be the last play of the third quarter. So, Otterbein goes into the fourth quarter trailing in this one, 48-14.
The Otterbein University Department of Music and Friends of Music at Otterbein will present a fall collage concert tomorrow at 2 o'clock.
Been a tough game for the Cardinals so far. Hopefully they can, you know, get some more points on the board here in the fourth quarter and make this one look a little bit more respectable in the final scorebook.
I think that's all you can hope for at this point.
Yeah, is they trail by 34 points. The only way that missed extra point would matter is if Otterbein can rally for 5 unanswered touchdowns in the fourth quarter.
Jeff, have you ever seen 5 unanswered touchdowns in the fourth quarter?
I can't say that I've seen it personally.
Neither have I.
So,
nor have I ever heard of one.
They could try to win this one 49-48, but it's unlikely to happen.
All right, the Cardinals.
Fourth quarter begins. Otterbein football, first and 10 at their own
45.
We'll
set up for the fourth quarter.
And now it's Hammond in the backfield. They're going to hand it to Hammond, who goes up the middle. And he dives forward across the 45 to the 46 for a gain of 5 yards on first down.
That's interesting. They switched up their back man to Hammond instead of Piles.
Yeah, he hasn't gotten a carry. That was his first carry of the game. So maybe they just want to get him a little bit of playing time today. Keep him fresh for next week's game.
Andy Schultz on that last stop.
As Green looks to pass again, he's going to float it over to Hammond, but it's a little bit low, and Hammond can't handle it. We'll bring up a 3rd down and 5 for the Cardinals.
3rd and 5 at 46.
Well, in brighter news, it still hasn't rained out.
Yeah, you know, it was expected to be a little bit poor weather. But the rain has stayed away. It rained earlier this morning, but nothing now and nothing throughout the game. 3rd down and 5 from the 46 for Otterbein. Screen will take the snap, looking to pass. Rolls out to his right, finds a man. That's Hammond. He hits him. He breaks a tackle, spins out of another tackle, and is tackled forward across the 40. Down to the 37-yard line.
And that was excellent footwork by Speedy Hammond, number 20.
Yeah, makes the catch, avoids the initial tackler, and then spins out of another tackle before diving ahead towards the 37-yard line. Green to pass again. Looking deep over the middle. He hits Logan Stepp, and Stepp makes the catch.
Kevin Green's pass complete.
Stepp makes the catch down to the 20-yard line. So a nice pickup there. It's good enough for another first down. 17-yard pass play.
Gain of 17 to the 20. Otterbein football, first and 10.
Green to pass yet again. He's looking for the end zone. He throws into double coverage. He was looking for Julian Lowe, and that was a poor decision by Green. As he threw into solid double coverage, that one was batted away. And ball's incomplete.
Second and 10 at the 20.
Cardinals looking to the sideline for the next play.
And with the Cardinals trying to extend this game with passes, this one could take a while to finish entirely here. Screen to pass again. Throws the same play for Logan Stepp, and Stepp comes down with it. This time, Stepp got single coverage, and he comes down with the pass in the end zone for the Cardinals. And that cuts into this lead of just a little bit. Brings the score to 48-20 with 13:33 to go here in the fourth quarter. The Otterbein offense is fighting. Now they just need a defense to come up with a few stops.
Yeah, that was a very clean 20-yard pass to step.
Cisse attempting the extra point, Kevin Green holding.
Cisse in to kick the extra point with Green as the holder. Kick is up. And it is good. So, 48-21 is the score now as Baldwin Wallace still leads with 13:33 to go in the fourth quarter. And you know, I wonder if at any point Otterbein will attempt onside kicks to try and potentially get back into this game. You think you might as well try it now because you don't know when you're going to score again.
Absolutely.
But we'll just have to wait and see if they go for it.
Otterbein scoring drive, 7 plays, 76
onside
yards.
Kicks, always a risky play to choose.
But down 27 points, it's not like you're really risking anything there. Not like you're going to let the game get away from you down by 27.
Very true.
Baldwin Wallace comes out expecting a regular kickoff. Mount Union now leads Wilmington 69-0. In the third quarter of that game.
Joe Sanfilippo kicking off for Otterbein.
Mount Union, who the Cardinals
Austin
will be playing
State
next week.
Yeah, and if their defense can't stop Baldwin Wallace, you got to worry about what's going to happen next week. As Sanfilippo kicks this one away, it's a regular kick. And it'll be fielded at the 20-yard line by Austin Smith. And he runs into his own man, now breaks through, and he's got room to run. He's across the 40, the 30, the 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Baldwin Wallace. So you probably should have kicked the onside kick there.
I would have gone with the onside kick there.
I don't think that would have been returned for a touchdown.
Or at least you would hope not.
And that was Adam Blake on the kick return. Fielded at the 20-yard line, ran into a crowd, pushed his way through, spun out, and returned it all the way for a touchdown.
Looking over to the booth next to us, the radio men from Baldwin Wallace. In much better spirits, I would assume.
Yeah, you know, anytime you can put it up over 50 points, I think you've had a pretty good day. And that is exactly where Baldwin Wallace is right now as they wait this extra point. Kick is up. It's good. And that makes the score. Baldwin Wallace 55, Otterbein 21.
And yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is indeed a football game.
Football, not basketball.
Not basketball.
Although this may be a score we see with the men's basketball team as well at some point during the season. They've struggled in recent years.
Being a first year, I'm not experienced with the Otterbein basketball team. Are you making any predictions, Jeff?
You know, I'm hoping they can do better than last year, and to do that, they need 6 wins. If they can get 6 wins, they'd do better than last season.
If you don't mind me asking, how many wins did they have last year?
They had 5 wins last season.
Oh, okay.
So hopefully they can get to 6 this year.
Riley Jones kicking off for Baltimore.
They've got a new head coach, so some promise there.
Speedy Hammond. And Christian Johnson receiving for Otterbein.
Speedy Hammond and Christian Johnson receiving for Otterbein.
Hammond hasn't really had too much room to work on these kick returns recently.
No, always being brought down around the 25-yard line.
Looks like Heidelberg has decided to kind of take it easy. This one is kicked off to Hammond around the 3-yard line. He tries to come right. He slips down, and he's inside the 20.
Speedy Hammond on the return for Otterbein.
So
Tyrone Brenninger and Brian Steff combined on the stop.
Heidelberg looks like they may have just scored, potentially get up to 70 points against Marietta. Keep an eye on that one, see how many points they can score. Mount Union's currently at 69 against Wilmington.
Just a weekend of high-scoring games, Jeff.
Yeah, it's probably the highest scoring week in the conference, I would estimate. Baldwin Wallace 55, Heidelberg, it's like they just went to 70, Mount Union at 69, John Carroll with 48, and Ohio Northern with 42. Green looking to pass. Looking deep, and he holds on to it and just gets run over by three defensive linemen. Should have gotten rid of that one, decides to hold on to it, and he pays a price for it. He's run down.
Charkham Bonaparte on the tackle for Baldwin Wallace.
By a hive of hornets.
A hive
or,
of hornets.
Or
yes.
Yellow jackets, I suppose, is the case here.
Love the descriptors.
Yeah. 3 yard loss, second down.
Otterbein will set up at the 15 yard line.
Second and 13 from the 15. Hammond remains in the backfield. Green to pass. Looking over the middle, has a man, hits him. Catch is made out to the 25. To the 24, that's Joey Beatty with the reception.
Nate Furster on the stop.
And if you look at the stats for Otterbein, you know, they look pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
You've got Kevin Green, he's 21 of 33 for, you know, 225 yards, and John Piles has 11 carries for 105 yards, and Green throws this one. The catch is made just enough for the first down there. It's Joe Beatty once again. There's flags all over the field.
Now, Jeff, I think I did say at the start of this game that I wanted to see more passing from Green, and it seems to be working in the second half. I just think it's too late.
Yep, that is true, and they're going to decline the offsides again as they complete the pass for 6 yards.
Jake Carter on the stop of the yellow.
Well,
jacket.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're still with us, we thank you.
Yeah, it's been a rough one for the Cardinals, but the offense is still trying to get some points. So everyone loves points. And Green to pass. Throws it deep down the far sideline, overthrows his receiver again. Had some trouble with that. There was step he was trying to hit down the left sideline. Overthrew him. Falls incomplete. Brings up a second down and 10.
Second and 10 at the 29.
I think both teams are just ready for this game to be over.
Yeah, you know, but with Otterbein continuing to throw the ball, it'll extend this game. Extend the length. As Green looks to pass. And he throws it short out to Hammond, and Hammond gains about 4 yards. And unfortunately for the Otterbein men's soccer team, they were unable to get any goals in overtime. They end with a 2-2 draw after double overtime with Baldwin Wallace. So not a loss there, but a game they were hoping to win. Baldwin Wallace only 4 wins on the season. But it will take the draw on the road in 2-2 fashion after double overtime. As Otterbein here looks to try and get some more points on the board with Green in the empty backfield set. He throws quickly, and he's unloaded upon. Had to throw quickly.
Kevin Green's pass intended for Connor.
Falls incomplete.
Helmet knocked off on the
Yellow Jackets. When the Yellow Jackets players lost their helmet, he came in so hard to hit Green.
And
now Otterbein will have to punt this one away. Sanfilippo back in the punt after a stalled out drive, and this one goes well out of bounds. And where are they going to mark it?
Because
they're still coming up. He marks it at the 45-yard line, so not a great punt from Sanfilippo. And the Yellow Jackets will start from their own 45, leading in this one 55-21.
Well, Jeff, I'd like to see one more touchdown from the Cardinals just to try and save face a little bit.
Yeah, if they can get it up to 28 points, be be a success, I'd say, at least offensively. Mm-hmm.
We've got guys like Piles and Stepp having excellent games.
Yeah, both guys have had very nice games, and now here's a little quick shovel inside from the Yellow Jackets, and that was
Jordan Leverett with the carry.
Jordan Leverett, who got that touchdown catch earlier, catches that one on the forward flip from the quarterback and gains about 7 yards on the play, so a nicely designed play there.
48, second down three.
Just 10 minutes left in this quarter.
Yeah, 10 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. As they motion this receiver into the backfield, here's the handoff up the middle. And plowing ahead for the first down is the running back.
Adam Blake on the carry.
Is Adam Blake. Picks up first down yardage. Out to the Autobahn 44.
Gain to the 44. Baldwin Wallace football, first and 10.
They're just letting this play clock run down. Expect them to snap the ball under 10 seconds on the play clock every time now. That looks like that's what they're going to be doing. As this one is shoveled forward to Leverett again. And he's around the corner. He's down to the 35, and he picks up another 9 yards. It's got the backup quarterback in the game, Robbie Plagans, now. There's no reason to leave Moglen in there any longer.
No reason for the Yellow Jackets to risk an injury on Moglen.
He's had a very successful game, and the backups are in there for Baldwin Wallace. Get a second and one from the 35, a Lauterbein. Plagans lets the play clock run. Lets it run down under 10 seconds. Going to be a lot of standing around at the line of scrimmage here. He ticks down to 5. Takes the snap, hands it off up the middle to Blake. Blake sheds a tackle, pushes forward out across the 32 for a first down. So all the running backs for Baldwin Wallace have really had some contribution to this
Peter
game.
Carpenter on the tackle.
Got Reed, 84 yards and 3 touchdowns. Moglen's run it for 50 yards and a touchdown. Blake has 47 yards. Smith has 31 yards. So
a
bunch of guys contributing. Pick up another first down. They check the sideline to burn some more time. Play clock goes under 10 seconds. Or under 8 minutes to go here. Plagans takes the snap, hands it off to Blake. Blake dives to his right and gains a yard down to the 31. This is the ultimate clock burner right here.
Right.
When you've got the team that is content to run the ball and run the play clock down to under 5 seconds every play. Lots of standing around, but it kills the clock.
Second down and 9. The Yellow Jackets will be content to just talk among themselves a little bit before actually starting the play.
Yeah, there's still 15 on the play clock, so 10 more seconds to go before they really snap it. There's now under 7 minutes to go in the game. Plagans calls for the snap, takes it, hands it. Nope, he keeps it himself, avoids the initial tackler, and then is brought down for a loss of a yard. Keep the clock running.
No gain on the play.
I'll give a small shout-out to all the cameramen working today on a crisp 63 degrees outside.
Yeah, it feels chilly up here. It's overcast, no real sun out today. Doing a great job down there. and a game that's not been too exciting to stick around with.
And unfortunately, on a weekend that Otterbein is having more people than usual, considering it is family weekend, parents weekend.
Baldwin Wallace, here's a flip forward. Leverett again, and he's ahead across the 25 down to the 24. He'll be about 2 yards short of the first down.
Kyle Blues and Drew Irvin on the stop.
Looks like Baldwin Wallace will go for it just to burn some more clock here.
Oh, why wouldn't you at this point?
Leading in this one by a solid 34 points. Plagan's just standing around up there at the line of scrimmage, waiting for the play clock to run down. Looks like it got set late there, as it's just getting to 15 now. We dip under 5 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. The last few plays have taken up a good chunk of time here. Flagans takes the snap, rolls to his right, throws it quickly, and it's dropped. And that's the second stop of the game for Otterbein, and the second time it's come on a drop pass that would have picked up a first down. Trevor George is well across the first down marker. Can't haul that one in, and it'll be a turnover on down. So only the second time Baldwin Wallace has been stopped today.
Second time they've been stopped today, and I'm sure to mention that the secondary quarterback is in. So.
Yeah, it's both stops come on drop passes, and the backup quarterback is in for Otterbein. It's Joey Longino. He hands this one off to the right. That's Kristen Johnson. He's out across the 30.
Kristen Johnson with the carry.
Up to the 31.
And Austin Steffen on the tackle.
4.5 to go in the fourth quarter of this one.
Gain of 7 to the 31. Second down, 3.
This one's handed off again to Johnson. He cuts back, pushes forward out to the 35. That's good for an Otterbein first down.
Sean Dishwitz and Damon Baldwin on the tackle.
Just as a bit of a comparison, last year Otterbein beat Baldwin Wallace 20-9. And a big improvement on the Yellow Jackets, Moguln, who only completed 11 of 27 passes last year.
And it was 9-0 Baldwin Wallace at halftime of that game. So a very big turnaround as this one's handed off to Johnson coming to the right side. He's tripped up and he dives forward out to the 40-yard line for a 5-yard gain on first down.
Yards to the 40, second down 5.
Game was much more a defensive struggle last year. This week it's really been all offense all day. Got 76 points put on the board in this one. As Longino looks to pass, throws it quickly out on the near side, and he gets the receiver. It's Tyler Sorg, who's a yard short of the first down out to the 44-yard line. And mercifully, he stayed in bounds as the clock continues to run.
Gain to the 44. Third down, 1.
Third and 1 for the Cardinals. Hand off up the middle to Johnson. Johnson bursts through into the second level. It was dragged down at the 50-yard line, so that's a first down.
Tackle by Sean.
2.5 to go in the fourth quarter.
6 yards to midfield. Otterbein football, first and 10.
Geno and Johnson have looked good so far on this drive in their brief experience as Johnson cuts up the middle down to the 43. So a nice 7-yard gain there on first down for Johnson.
And Sean Dishwitz. Gain of 7 to the Baldwin Wallace 43. Second down 3.
Second and 3 from the 43. Under 2 minutes to go now as Johnson gets the carry again, makes a move at the line of scrimmage, dives forward down to the 41, so he's a yard short of a first down. The fans want them to throw the ball. That would only serve to stop the clock.
Third down, one.
A minute 20 to go in the fourth quarter. Longino will hand to Johnson. Johnson plows forward. He's got the first down. Down to the 37.
Tackle by Sean Dishwitz.
On the snap, will be under a minute to go in this game.
Otterbein football, first and 10.
Longino gets the snap. Hands off to Johnson again. Johnson fights forward. He's across the 35.
Johnson on the carry.
He'll be bunked down at the 35. And we'll have one more snap in this game before the clock runs out.
Jake Carter and Ryan Steph on the stop. 2 yards to the 35. Second down, 8.
We're under 30 seconds to go now. Longino takes it, hands off to Johnson. Johnson tries to bounce it outside, spins forward. He's tackled down at the 32-yard line, and that will be the last play of this ball game. Mm-hmm. As Otterbein is going to fall here today at home against Baldwin Wallace. I'm going to lose this one by a final score of 55-21, and the story of the game was the Otterbein defense being unable to get any stops. They had 2 stops the whole game, and both of those came on dropped first down receptions. So.
And you know, you have to feel a little bit of sympathy for that senior class. It was going for a 4-0 win streak against Baldwin Wallace, but just couldn't hold it.
Yeah, they just couldn't get it together. Didn't start out good. They went down 14-0, and they could not get the defense working today as they lose a big one, and Otterbein is going to fall now to 4-3 on the season and 4-2 in the OCC, in the OAC, excuse me, as they lose today 55-21 to the visiting Yellow Jackets of Baldwin Wallace. And we'd like to thank all our listeners for tuning in today as we had a tough game, but nice weather day, and we'd like to thank our listeners for tuning in here on OTB and WOBN. So thanks for listening. And
make sure to tune in next week as the Cardinals face Mount Union.
Bill, we've been here with Otterbein football, so we'll be back next week, and it'll most likely be Elijah Gonzalez and David Kinder. So thank you for tuning in, OTB, WOBN. Until next time.